Now, the second of Ray Suarez's global health reports from the Central American nation of Guatemala. Tonight, Ray looks at the many obstacles to family planning in that traditional society.
Every day, Evelyn Roquel travels the rugged countryside of Guatemala's highlands, teaching women about birth control. In a population where the fertility rate is the highest in Latin America, it's a daunting task. Evelyn works for Women's International Network for Guatemalan Solutions, called WINGS. Not surprisingly, the highest fertility rates are in the hardest-to-reach areas of the country, places reached mainly by boat, like the villages that surround Lake Atitlan.
I travel to very far-off places. I typically go to places several times, over and over again. When I first come to a community, I am met with a lot of resistance, but I keep coming.
Here, populations are overwhelmingly Mayan and overwhelmingly religious. Women typically have 8, 9, 10 children.
The culture and mindset here makes birth control very difficult to discuss. It's so embedded that the number of children is what God gives you. It's out of your hands. So for most women, this is a very new theme, which breaks with their traditional cultural values.
Buenos días a todas, señoras. Mi nombre es Evelyn Roquel.
On this day, Evelyn is greeted by a huge crowd of women in San Marcos. It's a scene that plays out again and again as Evelyn travels throughout the region. Most of the women here have no idea what birth control methods are available to them, much less how to obtain them. But they are experts on their own lives. When Evelyn shows the crowd a picture of a pregnant woman with an infant on her back and a toddler in her hand, the reaction is immediate. They know women in that situation. Some of them have lived it themselves. Family planning isn't always a question of fewer pregnancies. Better spaced childbirth is better for their health and their children. Evelyn Roguel says they're brave just to show up.
In these communities, it's the men who make the decisions about family planning. These women here, most do not have the support of their husbands. Many times they come to me and say their husbands will accuse them of sleeping around and being prostitutes if they use birth control.
In fact, it's such a sensitive subject that Evelyn's own safety is at risk. She requires women who ask for treatment or just for more information to sign a document proving they're voluntary participants. Those who are illiterate provide fingerprints.
I am Catholic and Mayan myself. I sing in my church choir, but I believe that giving a woman the ability to decide the number of children she wants is critical. It's vital for her health.
The United States government seems to agree. The Obama administration recently announced it wants to make family planning a top priority for global health funding. Dr. Rajiv Shah is the administrator for USAID.
Family planning has been underinvested in and is absolutely critical to the safety, security, and stability of many of the countries we work in around the world. There is so much data that shows that as total fertility rates go down in countries, the health and welfare of children, families, and frankly of the community overall goes up.
Health officials say family planning saves lives.
In the towns and villages strung along the shoreline of Guatemala's Lake Atitlan, you'll find some of the Western Hemisphere's largest indigenous communities and the hemisphere's highest rates of maternal mortality, death in childbirth. But when you talk to women about their lives, it's easy to understand why so many continue to risk early death with 8, 9, 10 pregnancies.
Concepcion Ramirez Reanda's mother, Maria, died while giving birth to her 11th child. At the time, Concepcion was 19 years old and was given the responsibility of raising her 7 younger siblings. Concepcion's now husband, Diego Chichom Ramirez, says the family was devastated.
When Maria, their mother, died, the family disintegrated and was torn apart.
But even with this firsthand tragedy, Concepcion defers to her husband about any family planning. Diego refuses birth control interventions.
We will follow God's will. We believe this is natural law, and we have heard too many stories about birth control, like injections and pills that cause cancer.
Stories about the dangers of birth control are often linked to religion, where family planning methods such as monthly pills, tubal ligation, and IUDs have long been against church teachings. Oscar Julio Vian Morales is Guatemala's archbishop.
The problem is the kind of birth control methods that are used, like forcing families to sterilization for life. Foreign governments should not insist on less children, but on more education, more health services, and work.
For their part, health officials say family planning is one strategy to help turn around Guatemala's dire health needs. Years ago, more children meant more hands to work the land. But generation after generation, farms are divided into smaller and smaller plots. There's less food to harvest. And with big families comes more mouths to feed. Nearly half the population of Guatemala suffers from chronic malnutrition.
You know, if you look at Guatemala, 46% of children are stunted. And that means if you just put them against a wall and draw a line, they are on average significantly shorter than they should be for their age. And that is reflective of a certain type of chronic nutritional deficiency.
At Hospitalito Atitlan, a small private hospital funded largely by international donations, malnutrition is a common sight. This four-year-old weighs only 18 pounds, and she's lost 1 pound since August. Andres Botran is a former secretary of nutrition for the previous Guatemalan government.
Malnourished children have 12 points less of IQ than a normal child. We will have a great majority of the population with diminished mental capacities. That is a risk not only for, you know, economic development, health, et cetera, but the viability of our democracy.
Even if women want birth control, getting contraceptives to remote areas poses a logistical challenge. So mobile units are dispatched by the Guatemalan Family Planning Association, APROFAM. The group transforms local office space into operating rooms, offering tubal ligations and slow-release hormone implants. Dr. Lisbeth Contreras is one of the gynecologists for APROFAM.
We cover the whole country, but it's difficult. There is a huge demand. These are bad financial times in Guatemala, and it's hard for families who have many children.
43-year-old Dora Ileana Orellana came with her daughter-in-law, Julia Maria, to the clinic. Dora has a child the same age as her grandson, less than 2 years old, her seventh child.
My body can't hold children anymore. I'm too weak. Already I have headaches, my bones hurt, and I'm worn out from housework.
Both grandmother and daughter-in-law received Jardel, a hormone implant in the upper arm, which acts much like birth control pills.
My mother had 13 children, but times are harder now. Everything is really expensive. And sometimes I'm in trouble because I have no money to feed my family.
Over 40% of Guatemala's population is younger than 15. Family planning advocates realize they must target the young. Here, in a community outside Antigua, school-age children become voluntary peer educators, steering their classmates away from early parenthood. This program is also run by WINGS. Janine Simon, the executive director of WINGS, says schools are a platform for both genders.
It's important for the kids to be comfortable talking about the topic amongst their peers of both sexes. This is a very machista society here where the men, the boys, are brought up to believe that they have rights over the girls or the women. And I think that helps also if they're learning together and they can see that the power that the girls have through their education and their intelligence and their wisdom.
Programs like these are likely to gain traction from the administration's Global Health Initiative. But with strong opposition from Congress, on the overall levels of foreign aid, any future funding remains unclear.
We have much more about Guatemala online, Fine Ray's reporter's notebook, and a story about how gang violence targets bus drivers in Guatemala City.